friend.
Good afternoon.
Okay, Chockalingam, also known as Chucks, also known as Chukku. So he's doing his first project from the Advanced Communication Manual. He has selected the manual Storytelling, and this is his first speech from the 10 speeches in the Advanced Communication Bronze series. So today he has taken the project number one, the folk tale, from the Storytelling Manual. The objectives are to tell a folk tale that is entertaining and enjoyable for a specific age group, to use vivid imagery and voice to enhance the tale. Timer, please note this time is 7 to 9 minutes.
Good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters and guests.
Good afternoon.
There are a lot of characters in Mahabharata, but I love this particular character. I admire this character, Karna. If you see, Karna is the most unfortunate character depicted in Mahabharata, because he was abandoned, he was rejected, he was deprived of all his due respect for no fault of his. Yet this character portrayed loyalty, genuinity, generosity, and greatness in every point of time. So I love this character a lot. Today I'm just going to tell about the last 2 days of this character, Karna. So before this, I want to tell you about 3 backstories. The first backstory is, Krishnan is an intelligent guy. So he knows for sure that Pandavas cannot win Kauravas with Karna with his full power. So he wanted to do something to reduce his power. The first thing that he took is emotional thing. He revealed the bitter truth to Kunti Devi that Karna was your kid. So Kunti Devi felt very happy and she met Karna. That was a beautiful thing. That was an emotional thing. Because for the very first time, the son is looking at his mother. And for the second time, the mother is looking at her son. So they were really happy because Karna found his origin. So for everyone had humiliated him, but now he found his origin. At this point of time, Kunti Devi asked Karna to join Pandavas. But he told, in all of my low times, my friend Duryodhana stood with me. But now it's time for me to pay back. So I'm not going to join with Pandavas. But still Kunti Devi did not want Pandavas to get destroyed by the hands of their own blood. So she asked him to fulfill 2 promises. The first promise is, he should not kill any of the Pandavas. Karna, being the arch rival of Arjuna, promised her that except Arjuna, no one would be slain by him. Second promise is, he should not use Nagastra. It was a fearful attack. He should not use the Nagastra more than once. 2 promises. Backstory number 2. Karna learned his art of warfare from Parasurama, who was also cursed him that he would forget what he had learned when he meet his greatest enemy. Backstory number 2. Backstory number 3. 15 days have gone. Arjuna was very angry because Kauravas killed his son Abhimanyu. So he promised to take revenge on each and every one of Kauravas. He was also angry. These are the 3 backstories that you should know. So now we are going on the end of day 15 of Kurukshetra. Day 15 ended. So it was a big backlash to Kauravas because Dronacharya was dead. Already Bhishma was also dead. So Duryodhana felt the only person who is worthy enough to be the commander-in-chief was none other than Karna. And also he firmly believed that Karna could uproot the Pandavas. Because Drona and Bhishma had some partiality towards Pandavas. But Karna, on the other hand, is close friend. He strongly believed him. Day 16, Karna led the Kauravas army as decided. And he used Madara Vyugam, and on the other side, Pandavas used Ardhachandra Vyugam. There are some Vyugam kind of it. And everyone were fighting at every end of, from every end. When you see Nakula, the fourth Pandava, he was having his, he was riding his horse, holding swords on both his hands, killing all the soldiers on both the sides. He looked like a hawk swooping the soldier troops. Everyone was very frightened about Nakula. At one point of time, he met face to face with Karna. This hawk looked like a chick in front of Karna. So Karna just said, advised him to flee to Arjuna or Bhima because he had promised his mother that he would not kill any other Pandavas. So he went. Day 16 ended. It was bloodshed everywhere, but no big loss on both the sides. That night, Duryodhana approached Karna and told he had to do something with Arjuna because he was becoming a threat day by day. Karna assured him that the next day will be a doomsday, either for Arjuna or for Karna. And also he mentioned that he lacked an able charioteer like Krishna because Arjuna had Krishna. He told that. So they decided to bring Shalya. He was a great warrior. When Duryodhana approached Shalya, he felt insulted because they are calling him for a lowly post. But somehow they persuaded him to become his charioteer. Day 17 started. Karna made the Kurukshetra his home ground and thrashed the soldiers. On the other hand, Arjuna was equally strong and was wreaking havoc. But one thing, Arjuna was firm to kill Karna and charged towards him. All the sharp arrows from Arjuna's bow pierced through Karna's arrows, but it could not touch Karna's chariot. On seeing this, Yudhishthira, he got frustrated and he went to Arjuna and he told him, "What are you doing?" He asked, "Are you wielding the Gandiva or are you just wielding a mere twig?" He got insulted. Arjuna got insulted and suddenly his anger exploded and then he deployed a bunch of arrows towards Karna. And now Karna got injured. On the other side, Nakula was fighting with Vrishasena. Vrishasena was Karna's son. On that side, Vrishasena had an upper hand. But after Karna got injured, Arjuna joined Nakula. So Arjuna and Nakula are fighting against Vrishasena. Karna could not help them, but he joined, but he could not help with his full power. At one point of time, I told Arjuna was very angry with every Kauravas because they killed his son. Now he loaded his arrow and he addressed Karna. I told, "You killed my son. I'm just returning the favor." He shot the arrow right at Vrishasena, beheading his head. There was sound everywhere, but to Karna it was full of silence. He stood shocked and he started taking decisions without his full man. He wanted to shot the Nagashtra, which is what his mom told, "You should do it, you should use it only once." He shot it. At that point of time, Shalya told, "Aim at Arjuna's chest." But he didn't want to do it. Few minutes back, Arjuna killed his son on neck, shot the arrow. So he wanted to treat Arjuna the same way. So he aimed at his neck and he shot the arrow. At that time, Krishna, he stepped forcefully in the chariot and the chariot sank. Just think, Shalya knows this before. And that's why he asked Arjuna to aim at chest. But Karna was full of anger. He don't know what decision to take. And he aimed at the neck and the chariot, since the chariot went sink down. So the Nagashtra just hit the crown. And that's all, he can use it only once. In a turn of unwanted events, Karna's chariot wheel, it got stuck in the ground. He asked Shalya to push the chariot. But Shalya just turned and told, "I did not sign up for this." He got down and he went. He had no other choice. Karna had no other choice. He went down and he pulled the chariot wheel. At that point of time, Arjuna was showering arrows at Karna's on Krishna's advice. So now Karna was fully armed. He was like wounded, fully wounded. At this point of time, he decided, "Okay, now I have no other choice. I have to use my Brahmastra." At that point of time, Parasuram gave one bane to him, right? So he forgot the mantra to summon the Astra. He was full of wounded, he was full of arrows, but he's still alive. He was still alive. Krishna knew that's because of Karna's dharmas that holding him from death. So he turned himself into a Brahmana and he went and asked for alms. Karna didn't know what to do because he had nothing to give. He asked the Brahmana, "What do you want from me?" Brahmana just asked, "I want all your accumulated merits." without any second thought, he gave all his accumulated merits. Krishna got moved by his generosity and turned his form into Vishwarupa and told, ask one boon from me, I will give it for you. Karna thanked Krishna and he asked this one thing. In rest of my birth, in all of my birth, I should never say no to anyone under any circumstances. Krishna was very pleased with this and he gave that boon and he asked Arjuna to kill this guy. Arjuna, though first hesitated, the thought of Abhimanyu broke his second of reluctance. He shot an arrow and he was dead. And thus ended the life of a bravest soul. Karna, the son of Surya, the eldest of Pandavas, the rightful heir of Kuru throne, the best friend of Duryodhana, and the virtuous soul in the epic. Over to you, Pandava.
Let's have a big round of applause for all the people speaking.